A government minister has said the church does not have the exclusive right to say who can marry. Writing in the Daily Telegraph, the Equalities Minister Lynne Featherstone said the church does not own marriage and that the state is entitled to make changes. Well, the government is due to begin consultations in introducing same-sex marriage next month. Let's talk to Mike Judge. He's from the Coalition for Marriage, a campaign group which is against the government's proposed changes. And he joins me from Newcastle. A very good afternoon to you. Well, why should the church have the monopoly on marriage?
The church certainly doesn't have the monopoly on marriage. The Coalition for Marriage understands that the definition of marriage existed way before the Christian church. But I'd also say that the government doesn't own marriage, and I don't think Lynne Featherstone should be bulldozing ahead with plans to redefine it.
Is that the key to all of this, the use of the word itself? If it was something else, perhaps it wouldn't raise such high emotion.
Well, I think there is a great affection for marriage in our society. And I think particularly when people understand that the rights and the legal rights of marriage are available to same-sex couples through civil partnerships, I think people, majority of people, say that they don't want the meaning of marriage to then be redefined. I think if Lynne Featherstone really cares about what the people think about this, she should have asked the people. She never has asked the people. It's never been part of a party's manifesto. And from what we've read so far, it appears that the consultation is just going to be about how we redefine marriage, not whether we redefine marriage.
So give us your definition of marriage.
Well, I think marriage should be between one man and one woman. That's how it's been understood across cultures and across the world for thousands of years. I think that's how most people understand marriage.
You said just a few seconds ago it's up to people to decide. Why can't it be between two people?
Well, I think the majority of people want it to be between a man and a woman. That's how they've understood it. And I really don't think that the government owns marriage, and I don't think it's for the government to go ahead and redefine it over the heads of the people.
What do you mean by the majority, though? In your opinion, what percentage of the population perhaps would prefer to stay the way it is?
Well, our polling shows that when the public is presented with the facts, when they understand that the legal rights of marriage are already available through civil partnerships, 51% of them say, well, in that case, we don't want marriage to be redefined.
I just go back to my point about it being the word marriage again and the connotations that are around that. Why shouldn't it be available to everybody?
Well, of course, marriage is more than just a word, and it's more than just love between individual people. Of course it is that, but it's more than that. Marriage has a place in society, it has a place in our history, and it has a place in our culture as well. And if we change the meaning of marriage, then that will have a big impact on culture. And I think Lynne Featherstone in her article today talked about she wanted to shape society. I don't think marriage should be used as a piece of social engineering to shape society in the way that Lynne Featherstone wants it.
A debate that will rage on, I'm sure. Mike Judge, thank you very much for joining us.
You're welcome.